Right, so let us go for solving question number 4. Question number 3 is similar. This bar graph only is there, so you will be able to solve it. Question number 4 is little different. And we need to draw a histogram, right? Okay, so let us understand that part first. Yes. So question number 4. Now pay attention towards me completely. Pay attention towards here completely. Okay. Right. Now question, what it is? The length of 40 leaves of a plant are measured correct to 1 millimeter and the obtained data is represented in the following table. Right. Very good. So the table is given to us, the obtained data. And it is an interval. The data given to us in interval. So length of leaves in millimeter is given to us. And here number of leaves. Very good. So 118 to 126. Number of leaves are 3. And 127 to 135. Number of leaves are 5. Then 136 to 144. What are the number of leaves? 9. Okay, 145 to 153. Number of leaves are given are 12. Then comes to 154 to 162. 5. And 163 to 171. Number of leaves are 4. So this is called interval, class interval. It is also there, okay. So next one is there, 172 to 180. Okay, 172 to 180. How many are there? 2. Very good. So this is called class interval. Okay, now this class interval, as you have seen, that class interval should start from, this is called lower limit, this is called
higher,
upper limit. Okay, lower limit and upper limit. The class interval consists of two things, one is lower limit, one is upper limit. Now in any class interval in statistics, this upper limit should be equal to the next lower limit. Here upper limit of one interval should be equal to the lower limit of next class, means 126 or 126 should come here, but here one gap is there. There is a gap between higher limit of one class and lower limit of next higher class. For this, next higher class will be this one. For this, next higher class will be 136 to 144. Okay, so actually what is required? There is a requirement that if it is 126 here, 126 only should come here. And there should be a gap of equal interval should be maintained. But here that is not there. So the very first duty is to equalize these intervals. Equalize these intervals. This is our first and foremost job. Right, so how you will be going for equalization of that? There is a procedure and that is called, what is the difference between this upper limit and lower limit of next class? What is the difference?
One.
Difference of one is there? Okay, so 127 here is there, 126 is there, there is a difference of one. Okay, so that one, you can say upper limit of one class minus lower limit of next class. As it is higher, let me write lower limit of higher class minus upper limit of previous class. previous class. Okay. Divided by 2. Divided by 2. So, of lower limit of higher class is 127. 127. Upper limit of previous class. How much?
126.
Speak out. 126 divided by 2 will be equal to what? 1 by 2 is equal to
0.5.
Understood 0.5? Oh. So now what you are going to do to equalize the class interval? Equalize class interval. Reduce 0.5 from lower limit. Okay. And increase 0.5 from higher limit. Understanding this point? You understood, gentlemen?
Yes,
what we want to say?
Yes,
what you need to do, that 0.5. Suppose here gap of 2 is there. Then that will become 2 by 2. So 1 you have to reduce. So what you are going to reduce, there is the gap between upper limit of, sorry, lower limit of higher class and lower limit of upper limit of previous class, there is a gap of 1. So that's why 1 by 2 has come. If there is a gap of 2, 2 by 2 will come. If there is a gap of 3, 3 by 2 will come. Understood? So if this doubt is not there, then what you are going to subtract and add? No, very good. So now here, in our case, 0.5 has to be subtracted and added. So where we have to subtract? In the lower limit. In the lower limit. Okay. So this is, will become 117.5. Listen here, man, first. Okay. 118 minus 0.5 will give you what? 117.5. Okay. Here you have subtracted, here you will be adding. So if you add 0.5, then what you will get?
126.5.
Next class, you will start from 126.5. Correct?
Yes,
what you will be writing there?
Then 135.5.
Okay, 135.5. Next one, tell me, Bharat.
135.5.
Okay. Then?
144.5.
Okay, 144.5. Very good. Now, tell me next one.
144.5.
Okay.
153.5.
Very good. Next one, please tell me.
153.5.
Okay. 162.5.
Yes, Bharat, please tell. Sir, 162.5.
Okay, 162.5.
171.5.
Okay, next one.
Sir, 171.5.
Okay.
180.5.
180.5. Now continuation is there?
Yes, sir.
Now class intervals are continuous?
Yes, sir.
Earlier it was not continuous. So if you will be drawing like this, then it will be wrong. So now, this data, this class interval you have to take and this figure. Figure is same. Okay. This number of class, number of leaves, that is same. But now your interval has changed. Okay. And in this case you are going to draw histogram. So, what you are doing? Like this broken line you will be drawing. And then you will be drawing here. So, x-axis and y-axis. Here, you will start from 117.5. 117.5. Then 126.5, 135.5, 144.5, right, and then 153.5, 162,
180.5. Okay? So, this is length of leaves in mm. Okay, next one here. So, minimum is 2, 4, 5, maximum is 12. Correct? So, what you do? You go for from here 0 is there. So, we can go for 2, we can go for 4, we can go for 6, 8, 10, 12. In graph 3, if it is there, you can go for 1, no problem. Now, you can draw that histogram. Okay. So, number of leaves are 3. And that is 117.5 to 126.5. Number of leaves are 3. So, this is there. So, continuous class interval is there. So, that is, it is histogram. Histogram. Okay. 126.5 to 135.5. What is the figure? 5. So, somewhere here, like this, will be there. Okay, then comes to 9. So, figure 9. Okay, then comes to 12. All will be straight line. Okay, you have to use scale clearly. All will be straight line. Then 12 has come. Then 5 again. So 5 is this one only. So here we will be writing 3, 5, 9, and 12.
Five.
Then again 5.
4, 2.
Right, 4, 2. So 4 is there. Here 4 and then again 2. Very good. 4 and 2. Right? So this is called histogram. You can set like this. This is called histogram. Okay, gentlemen? Right. Now, suppose, if this question it is not there, suppose you want to draw frequency polygon. Okay, so frequency polygon, how you will be drawing? You will be joining the middle points of all. Like this, middle points will be there? Okay, so middle points of what? Middle point of this class interval? So that middle point, it is there. Okay, so these middle points you will be joining by straight line. Straight line. Okay, like this. And here, here also you need to join. So 117.5 is there and 126.5. Similarly, here also some middle point will be there. That middle point with that it will get joined. Here also it will get joint. So this is called frequency polygon. When question will come, that will see.
That time this ball and histogram.
Histogram will be there. Suppose histogram, after drawing histogram, you can draw. If suppose histogram is not asked, directly you can put middle point and you can join.
Sir, given, sir, is there say, any other
okay.
Graphical?
So that you can do it. Okay. So, other suitable graphical representation of this data is frequency polygon. So, frequency polygon in this way, middle points we need to join. Straight line. So, this is another straight line, this is another straight line. Just you will put a scale between these two middle points and you will be joining. One is there freehand sketching. Freehand sketching means like this you are doing, you are joining like this. No. Frequency polygon will consist of always straight lines. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good.
Sir, is there any suitable graphical representation?